What's up, everybody? It's Durag. We're back at it again with another news update on Ready or Not. So a French news organization that goes by No Frags did an interview with Void Interactive. Although it says that it is June 2014, which I don't know if that's a typo. I mean, if it is, then I might be reading an old article, but subscribers have told me that this is a new article. I mean, it says June 3rd, and today is the 3rd of June, so maybe the 2014 is just a typo. Content is content, I guess. But anyways, so a lot of this content I already knew about it, like consoles being confirmed. That was like, if you go through my series, I pretty much knew about a lot of this stuff. So I'm just gonna go through and tell you all the new things that have not been said, or at least I have not heard of. I've been covering this game a lot, so I already know about a bunch of the stuff that's in it. So I'm just gonna simplify it for you. Are there some aspects of the game that you had given up because of the time or resources it would need? We do need pre-order sales to ensure we get everything to how we want it. The only things that may not be a part of the first edition of the game are a female SWAT officer, a fully destructible world, and a battle royale mode. So this is new. I have not heard of this. Moving on. You are currently self-funded. Do you have any plans for the future regarding the game's financial aspect? For example, expanding the team? We have already managed to expand the team without recurring outside funding, but a cash infusion would be very useful. Thus, we are planning to offer the game for pre-order in July. Hopefully, this generates the funds to polish the game to the high standards of our fans. Regarding solo campaign, how many maps are you aiming for in time for release? Are you designing separate maps for multiplayer? We do not want to release the number of levels or maps just yet. We are more comfortable saying we have the blueprints designs for over 10 levels. Our goal is to deliver all these on original game release. That is new. Moving on. Your game will allow 8 players to finish a mission in co-op mode. Will there be players with particular roles? A command role, for example? How does the number of players affect the difficulty? No roles except for the squad leader. The rest of the roles are up to the players to define themselves. Up to 8 players will be able to finish co-op. More players will not affect difficulty from programming point of view, but should be more tactically complex. All missions will begin with the tactical analysis planning phase. What can be done during this phase? Pick your equipment, draw on the map, fly over the level with the drones? Players will get a situation overview, briefing, known suspect civilian bios, be able to select deployables, assign element colors, coordinate strikes with a map drawing, and choose personnel to help assist the player, such as snipers, floodlights, negotiators. Ooh! Will we be able to equip sniper rifles? Yes, there will be a few of these. While we appreciate the act of killing virtual suspects, will it be possible for the player to use non-lethal weapons, from taser to pepper spray, to complete the game? Yes. More points awarded for non-lethal completion. This one talks about the modding. Ooh, a legendary, very popular SWAT modder. I wonder who that one could be. Easy Street. What are your thoughts on Rainbow Six Siege and the arcade tactical FPS that succeeded when a lot of games struggled to have a stable player base? Prefer not to comment. Ooh. Drama. Are we going to be able to scream, "Police, drop your weapon!" when spamming a key? Yes. Player will select the key for this purpose, but you will also be able to do this via voice command. Cool, cool, cool. Given the graphic nature of the game and gritty realism it portrays, the game is for mature audiences, but can possibly be adapted to meet the needs of some of our more regulated target markets. We will also strongly recommend that people who have experienced personal traumatic events from criminal violence, hostage situations, or terrorism refrain from playing. At its core, the game honors the work of dedicated law enforcement officers across the world and in no way intends to glorify cowardly criminal acts. Damn right. We also aim to highlight the engineering design brilliance of organizations who produce fit for purpose, exceptional lethal and non-lethal weapons, tools that assist enforcement, maintain public order. People who purchase and play RON will undoubtedly agree that it is one of the funnest and most challenging games they have ever played. It will include beautiful and carefully constructed music and cinematics that will appeal to all the senses. The game will be variable in pace depending on scenario, from fast to eerily slow, as the police and aggressors plan their next move. We believe that RON will also deliver a great personal entertainment experience for those wishing to simply enjoy watching others play or create unique mod experiences. This article is great, but for me, A majority of it I already knew. So I gotta say, great job, No Frags. I'm gonna link the article here at the bottom of the screen right here. You can read all of it. The majority of it I already knew. I was just picking out all the stuff that was, you know, different. So this article is great for somebody that is really uninformed. It just gives you like a good gist of it. This is a great article. Good job, No Frags. How do you say that in French?
Bon travail.
I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch. I will catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.